Hi Virgo, it's Fee, and I thought I would just do a very quick reading for you for the month of February 2018. I'm just going to look at the energies and something that might come up for Virgo, rather than doing it on a weekly basis throughout the month. It's just an energy that's around you that I feel that could be a little warning sign. I've also pulled out a couple of cards, one for romance cards, for people that are already partnered, and for those that are single. The cards I'm using are Serial Marchetti, and the Dorian Virtue cards are the Romance Angel cards. Right guys, let's get started. For Virgo, let me see. I feel looking at the cards you've pulled, Virgo, you've got the World card, the Devil card, the Five of Cups, and the Eight of Cups. And I feel that looking at your cards, that you feel that in the month of February, the beginning of the year, there's got to be more to life than this. This is what I feel. Because starting right away, you've got the World card. And it's almost like you're questioning that you want a change. You want to break away because you've got the Devil card here. And the Devil card to me is always, it's like what no longer is going to hold you back. It's keeping you dependent on something, like a codependent relationship, or breaking away from bad habits like smoking, drinking, anything that is not for your best, your higher self, your higher purpose. You're going to move away from that. I feel that it's been a month where, you know, like, so January, people always make New Year resolutions, if you like. Well, I feel in this in February, yous are definitely going to do it. Whatever kept yous held back before, guys, yous are moving away from this. Because right next to that, you've got the Five of Cups. And as you can see, I feel that you're looking at what you're going to leave behind, right? You're looking at to make this move and get away from what no longer serves you. What are you leaving behind? And there's a hold there. There's a real hold. If it's a relationship you're moving away from, you could be looking at what you're going to lose. Are you going to lose your home? Are you going to lose parts of your family, extended family? But then you've got to look at, but what's there behind you? There are things there that, hope, if you like. There's your little cups of hope behind you, because I don't believe people walk away for nothing. Okay, I feel with Virgo, this has been something that's been happening for a while. Listen, I'm saying relationship. It could be a job. It could be anything that you no longer feel happy about. You need a change. This can't be it. It could even be your mindset, your belief system, that you're now wakening up to something else, or something else there for you, and this is the past, and you're not going back there. Because here we have you here, the Eight of Cups, and you're definitely walking away from it. You've contemplated, and you've sat, and you've worried, and you had all these emotions going on, because you've known for quite a long time, I think, with this with these cards, Virgo, that you need to make a change in whatever aspect of your life that there is. Remember, look up your moon sign and your ascendant sign, which may give you a clearer view on what this particular issue is. Only you will know, because this is a general reading. But you are definitely walking away from, you're going to start something afresh. This is a great card, because what you've left behind, you're supposed to leave behind. You're not doing anything that's not for your highest good. You've known this for a long time. You're supposed to walk away, and you've not, and this is the time you're going to do it. Right, for the love cards we have here, we have the Dorian Virtue cards, and for those that are already in a relationship, we have children. Your love life is being affected by children. Guys, I'm wondering when I just read this, talking about walking away, if it is those of you that are looking upon a relationship, walking away, this is what's been holding you to start with, your children, your family. But let's have a look. Children. It's not the first person that stayed in a relationship because of their children. Well, let's see. The Romance Angels sent you this card because children are a significant factor in your love life. either you want them or you and your partner have kids who are influencing your love life. This is a factor to consider when you desire to improve your romantic future. The angels honour and support all expressions of love, and they're willing and able to help you with any issue connecting children. In addition, this card can signify that you or your partner's inner child is affecting your relationship. This may mean there's a need for playfulness or a light-hearted spirit, or it could signal that it's time to heal a childhood emotional wound. The loving nature of your inner child and children in general is supportive of healing work, especially when its intention is to bring in more love. So, there we go, guys. Children could be influencing how the rest of your life at the moment is panning out. For those of you who are not partnered, we have keep an open mind. Your soulmate may differ from your usual type and expectations. So you could be sitting right beside them. You don't even know that this is your soulmate. Let's see. K-L-N-P. L-K-L. The romance angel sent you this card as a reminder to stay open to the possibility of your soulmate appearing in a form that may differ from what you expect. This is especially true if you tend to date a certain type of individual. You drew this card to help you discover your soulmate. This card may signal that you've already been introduced to this person but have overlooked his or her romantic potential. Take the time to get to know the various individuals you meet, even if there isn't an initial attraction. At the very least, you will learn more about yourself and may make a new friend. I can just see all these Virgos looking at everybody in their lives and thinking, are you the one? Are you the one? Are you the next love of my life? I believe most people that you have that play a part in your life is a soulmate. As I said, it's not always romantic. And I think as you get older, the silly things that matter to you and a partner when you were younger don't matter that way anymore. It's more if they're a decent human being, I think, than somebody who's drop-dead gorgeous. Do you know what I mean? I think you tend to overlook the gloss. You overlook the glossiness of somebody. Obviously, it's nice if people smell nice and they look good. That's great, but I think we go deeper now. I would hope. I think as you get older, you go deeper. You go deeper than just the superficialness of people. Right, guys, I hope you've enjoyed that, Virgo. If you haven't already, subscribe, please do. I'm hoping to get an app called InstaGo. They've contacted me. And it would allow me to pull more cards. If someone texted and wanted to have a more expansive or ask a question about something I've said in one of these readings, it would allow you to do so. So I'll keep everybody posted about that. Okay, well, I hope you enjoyed that. Give us a thumbs up if you liked it and subscribe. Speak to you soon.